This is Shattered Mind, a Cooper Trace suspense thriller, book one, written by Ella Swift, read by Jack.
Prologue. Who's a good dog? The golden retriever bounded up to Lily Alvarez and jumped up in excitement. Lily rubbed her ears, singing, "Oh, you're a good dog. Yes, you are. Yes, you are." Peaches was the dog's name, and she had boundless enthusiasm and endless energy. She flopped her paws onto Lily's shoulders and licked at her face. All right, Lily laughed. You'll get your food with the rest of them soon enough.
No.
Lily opened the back door to let Peaches out to join the other dogs. Most people had a collection of some sort. For Lily, it was dogs. She had only meant to get one, a companion to share her home. But one visit to the Humane Society had led to another. And 3 years later, she had 6 jobs and a voluntary position. There was the faint crunch of someone stepping on the gravel at the side of the house. Lily stood at the door and listened, sticking her head out to check if anyone appeared. Bernie, the large Saint Bernard, rounded the corner, and Lily sighed in relief. Not that she had anything to worry about. Lily left the door ajar and opened the dishwasher, even though the drying light was still on. 6 metal dog bowls took up most of the upper shelf and were too hot to handle just yet. Lily left them to cool and continued with her other chores. She lived alone, so the chores didn't take up a whole lot of her time, and she wasn't the messy sort. She removed the garbage bag from the small bin and left it by the door before replacing it with a fresh one. Then she grabbed the dusting rag and went through to the living room. Lily walked fully into the room and stopped dead. She knew he was behind her. She could sense him in the silence and should have run but slowly turned around to face him. She did not recognize the man standing in her house. He had a pallid, stony face and glassy eyes. He was taller than her, and while not overly muscular, she knew he could overpower her if he wanted to. Her eyes flickered to his hands. They were empty as far as she could see. The most terrifying thing about him was the way he stood there, unmoving, staring straight at her, not even a blink. It was not a case of a confused individual entering her home by mistake or a man come to rob the place. She knew from his stare that he had come for her, and his intentions were evil. Flight, fight, or freeze. Lily wanted to run. She would even choose to fight. Her body froze, her eyes the only part of her that could move. His actions mirrored hers, standing still in the same spot she had found him in when she turned around. And she knew instinctively that as soon as she moved, he would move. Lily scanned the room, looking for a weapon to defend herself. Her eyes caught a second figure, and she almost screamed. There was no one else. It was the same man reflected in the large mirror on her wall, but as she looked into it, he was staring straight at her from beyond the glass. She looked back at him, and he had also turned back to face her. The fear finally caught up with her, and Lily ran for it. The man stood still as if he knew what was coming. Lily caught her ankle on the coffee table and stumbled. She reached out her arms, fell onto the couch, and tried to push herself up quickly. The plush cushions embraced her as if pulling her into their embrace and toward her death. She finally managed to push herself back to her feet and turn to... Lily screamed. The man was there, the glint of a sharp blade in his hand.
No.
Lily screamed again, drawing some barks from the backyard, but none of the dogs came. They sensed the danger and stayed away. She moved as if submerged in water, ice-cold syrup that slowed her down. The living room became a contrast of silence and piercing noise. Lily's scream rang in her ears, engulfed in the silence. Everything was slowed and quietened by the man's presence in the room. Lily found herself confused in her panic. Then another piercing sound, a loud crack and smash, followed by a bell-like tinkling. Shards of glass rained down around Lily, some scratching at her skin. Danger surrounded her as the pieces of mirror fell to the ground, reflecting shards of herself. In the moment before her impending doom, Lily saw beauty. She was mesmerized by the blades of reflection. The back of her head exploded in pain. She fell forward, her brain still working, but her body not. She saw her eyes, dozens of reflections of her pale blue eyes, growing bigger and bigger in the shards as she fell toward the ground. There was terror there, but acceptance too. She did not want to die, but knew she would. Her body thudded to the ground, falling to her side. Lily could see what was ahead splayed across the gray carpet. Colors danced on the mirrored shards, and beyond them were his black shoes. The man stepped forward, and Lily closed her eyes tight, the strength drained from her body. Her body shut down and the darkness behind her eyelids became an eternal blackness. Chapter 1.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.